So, John had mentioned that you had a discussion regarding the human soul. There's some science behind this, whether it exists or not. What's your opinion?
My opinion is that science on the topic really doesn't matter all that much. I know there have been attempts to defend it in terms of science, or and I think it's there's sort of a scientism which says if you can't quantify it, it doesn't exist.
They tried to in movies and different theories.
Yeah, and I think that usually just leads to a lot of sort of woo and mystification. To say the human soul doesn't exist is like to say the Mona Lisa doesn't exist because it's not reproducible or something like that. That's kind of silly.
Just because we can't quantify it or we can't see it doesn't mean it doesn't exist.
Science has a lot of difficulty with consciousness, right? And we'd like everything to be reducible to genetics. You know, it's obviously a lot of we're in a time when a lot is being discovered in science.
True.
But to imagine that we're instantly going to get to a place where we can say, this is the soul, right?
There will be no soul formula, right?
Yeah. Correct. So I'm pessimistic about getting to some kind of soul formula through science anytime soon, anytime remotely soon. But I don't think that invalidates it. I think, I'm trying to remember, Stephen Hawking, for instance, went and attacked philosophy, fairly recently. And I think that's just arrogance. Somebody who doesn't really, somebody who really hasn't looked at the issues. That would be like me attacking physics. Or, I'm not a trained philosopher. I'm not a trained physicist.
Speak to what you know.
Yeah.
You're an opera singer.
Yeah.
What inspired you to be an opera singer?
Yeah.